Hi everyone, in this video we're going to be talking about what the substantial time derivative is. In the previous two videos, we talked about the partial time derivative and the total time derivative. To understand these concepts intuitively, we stated that we are holding a cube in a room of floating blue spheres, and observing the concentration of spheres in our cube at any given time. To find the partial time derivative, we said that we could find it by holding our spatial coordinates for our cube constant. By not moving our cube, we know that the only way the concentration in our cube control volume can change is going to be with time. We then expanded this idea and said, well, what if our control volume is moving around the room as we walk around? Well, then we need a total time derivative, which is the summation of the partial derivatives for all the components that make up our multivariable concentration function. This was represented by the following equation. Now that we're all caught up, let's add one more complication. Let's say that we are now holding our cube, but the airflow in the room is pushing us and all of the surrounding spheres in a direction at some constant velocity. Let's call this velocity alpha. So, we and all of our surroundings are getting pushed at the velocity of the airflow. Just note that alpha is a velocity, so it has a magnitude, which is how fast it is pushing everything, and a direction, and is therefore a vector quantity. This is important as it means that we can break the velocity of our movement down into its constituent components, kind of like we did for the total time derivative. Therefore, we can write the substantial time derivative for our above problem like so. Note that the substantial derivative is always denoted by a capital D instead of a lowercase d that we are accustomed to in the total time derivative. This type of derivative is very common when our whole problem is moving at some velocity, for example. So, for example, if you are studying a river flowing at some velocity, and then added a contaminant into your river and wanted to see how it worked its way through the river, you could use a substantial time derivative, as your whole problem is moving at some constant velocity. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding about what the total time derivative is in transport phenomena and why it is useful in the study of transport phenomena. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.